So here we have it, ladies and gents. I've imported the frames I extracted into GIMP, and we're moving in to have a look where this supposed object is. And oddly enough, it's looking just like a bit of cloud. Now, I'm going to adjust levels, just so I can see the pixels a bit better, and so can you. So we're going to drop them down, and there we have it. Lots of pretty pixels. And where I'm circling is where this object is supposed to be. And I ain't seeing nothing. So, let's move on to the blow-up that Mr. BBBB329 did. And we'll zoom in and have a look at the pixels here. Bearing in mind that shape is where that cloud was supposed to be. So, again, we're going to adjust the levels to help bring out the pixels so we can see the pixeling. And the odd thing is how fine the pixels are around the object, or of the object, whereas the sky is slightly coarser. So I think someone's being a prat, and they faked it. So well done, chaps, for being a bunch of morons. You're not fooling anybody. And whilst we're here, has Scott dredged up the doctor's drawing of a sun simulator? Only 300 feet in diameter. It doesn't work. It will not illuminate enough of the Earth's surface. So you're talking shit. It's only the size of the ISS. And here's a picture of the ISS transiting the sun. Can you see the problem now? You also have to bear in mind that with the sun being so big, its rays of light are practically parallel to the Earth. So the shadows would be thrown all over the shop. Sundials left, right and centre, which are still used as ornamentation, would suddenly not be working very well. Changing of the season notwithstanding, but people who have them tend to correct them for that. So, you're talking bollocks. The solar sim does not work, doesn't exist. Get over it. Please find links in the description box that take you to some videos explaining why it's utter bollocks.
Yeah.